To ban or not to ban? That is the question. Not for Hamlet, but for the U.S. Supreme Court. On Monday, the High Court's 9 justices cleared much of the way for Donald Trump's travel restrictions to go ahead. They limit entry to the U.S. for nationals from 6 Muslim-majority countries: Libya, Iran, Somalia, Sudan, Yemen, and Syria. The U.S. president claimed victory. "My number one responsibility as commander-in-chief is to keep the American people safe," Trump said in a statement. "Today's ruling allows me to use an important tool for protecting our nation's homeland." Trump introduced the ban's initial version just 1 week in office. It caused chaos at airports and in the courts, which ultimately blocked it. The White House introduced a revised version in March. It faced a similar fate. The administration claimed national security and executive powers. Critics denounced the ban as religious discrimination and executive overreach. The Supreme Court said it will decide in October which side is right. In the meantime, in an apparent compromise, it said the ban won't apply to anyone who has a, quote, bona fide connection to the U.S.
That's incredibly vague language. Who's going to be making the decision? Presumably the same government who is trying to bar Muslim individuals from coming into this country.
The decision may cause a backlog in courts, as attorneys across the country file motions on behalf of immigrants or refugees rejected by U.S. officials after the ban goes into effect as early as Thursday. Well, the White House said it wanted the ban, 90 days on immigrants from those 6 Muslim-majority countries and 120 days on refugees from anywhere in the world, in order to review the U.S.'s screening process. The court says it expects that review to be completed by the government by the time the High Court hears the larger case on presidential powers. Roee Ruttenberg, CGTN at the Supreme Court.